evening. We hope you enjoyed our first piece titled Fanfare and Flourishes by James Curnow. While composing this piece, Curnow drew inspiration from Marc Antoine Charpentier's Te Deum and incorporated the music in the middle sections of the piece. Although Charpentier composed Te Deum sometime in the 1680s, it has only recently been rediscovered in 1953 by French musicologists.
Our next selection is Annabelle Lee by Douglas E. Wagner. This piece is based off of a poem by famous American Gothic poet Edgar Allan Poe. The poem tells the story of young love cut short by tragedy. The poem reads as follows.
It was many and many a year ago, in a kingdom by the sea, that a maiden there lived whom you may know by the name of Annabelle Lee. And this maiden she lived with no other thought than to love and to be loved by me.
I was a child and she was a child in this kingdom by the sea. But we loved with a love that was more than love, I and my Annabelle Lee, with a love that the winged seraphs of heaven coveted her and me.
And this was the reason that long ago, in this kingdom by the sea, a wind blew out of a cloud, chilling my beautiful Annabelle Lee, so that her high-born kinsmen came and bore her away from me, to shut her up in a sepulchre in this kingdom by the sea.
The angels not half so happy in heaven when envying her and me. Yes, that was the reason, as all men know, in this kingdom by the sea, that the wind came out of the cloud by night, chilling and killing my Annabelle Lee.
But our love, it was stronger by far than the love of those who were older than we, or many far wiser than we, and neither the angels in heaven above nor the demons down under the sea can ever dissever my soul from the soul of the beautiful Annabelle Lee.
For the moon never beams without bringing me dreams of the beautiful Annabelle Lee, and the stars never rise but I feel the bright eyes of the beautiful Annabelle Lee, and so all the night tide I lay down by the side of my darling, my life and my bride, in her sepulchre but there by the sea, in her tomb by the sounding sea.
Thank you. All right, I got a lovely reminder from our clarinet section leader to introduce myself. So my name is Mr. Robinson. I am the band director here. Tonight is a very exciting night. Not only is it our last concert of the year, our seniors' last concert ever, but we also get to celebrate a lot. So throughout the night, you will hear some announcements of winners for our outstanding member award, which is chosen from every class in the band, as well as our John Philip Sousa Award winner. So we have a lot to celebrate tonight. So getting the show on the road, we have our outstanding student awards. So first up, first of all, these are peer voted awards. So these are not chosen by me. These are chosen by the band. Our outstanding freshman award goes to McKenna Miller. That's embarrassing on my behalf. My bad. All right, our outstanding sophomore award goes to Mr. Nathan Johnson. We'll do just one more. We will do our outstanding junior award, which is given to Miss Shania Wehrman. Oh, she's up.
Good evening. I am Matthew Kane, and I play tenor sax in the Dodgeland High School band. The next piece we'll be playing is Chasing Sunlight. Chasing Sunlight was inspired by the experience of driving west into the setting sun, as if trying to keep up with the Earth's rotation to catch the last few rays of light before dusk. The steady eighth note motif throughout this piece represents the sense of urgency, while the soaring lyrical themes depict the warmth and radiance of a sun low in the sky. Just as the sun will always set, humans must accept the impermanence of all things in life, and make the most of every opportunity before it has passed. Chasing Sunlight also represents the ongoing pursuit of these opportunities.
Thank you.
Isn't that piece just wonderful? I love that piece. That was a piece that a handful of our students played at our Trailway South Honor Band, and I fell in love with it so much that I said, we need to play it. So, I hope you enjoyed that. So the next couple of awards we have for you today are our Trojan Pride Award, which is given to a senior, and our John Philip Sousa Award. Yes, so our Trojan Pride Award is another peer-voted award, so the members of the bands chose the recipient of this, but I have to agree with this. This person that won this award has been nothing but extremely enthusiastic about the music program and has been a solid member, always bending their schedule to make sure that they are here for our needs, even when it's very inconvenient for them. So the winner of our Trojan Pride Award is Mr. Louis White. All right, and I had to write out this next one because it's that important. So finally, I get the privilege to announce our 2022 John Philip Sousa Award winner. So this award was introduced in 1955 to honor one student in the high school band. The John Philip Sousa Award recognizes superior musicianship and outstanding dedication. Not only will the winner of this award receive a super cool plaque, desk plaque that I have hidden in here so nobody sees, but their name will also be engraved on our John Philip Sousa Award plaque in the band room, and it will stay there for decades and decades. So they really have a legacy in this band. So this year was extremely challenging to choose one person. All of our seniors have committed so much time and so much energy to building up our program that they all deserve recognition. Can all of our senior members of the band please stand? All right, can we get a round of applause for these members? All right, so the person receiving our John Philip Sousa Award today has shown outstanding leadership ability in their section, remarkable music skills, and has demonstrated dedication to the whole music program. This person not only played in concert band, but they also participated in solo and ensemble, honor band, and on top of this, this person also participated in show choir and musical for the past few years. So the winner of our 2022 John Philip Sousa Award is Miss Lori Klecker.
Our final selection for the concert band portion of tonight's concert is Legends of Rock, arranged by Paul Murtha. This piece includes popular songs such as Hit Me With Your Best Shot, Barracuda, Paranoid, and Rock and Roll All Night. On behalf of the entire Dodgeland Music Department, we want to express our gratitude and appreciation for your support this year. This year, we were able to return back to in-person performances, reestablish traditions, and create new memories. We could not have done any of this without your support. We encourage you to stick around for the remainder of the concert to support our choirs, and we hope you have a wonderful rest of your evenings. ¶¶
Thank you for sticking around. So this is the Trojan Jazz Band. We are in our first year, ending our first year, but I would say it has been an extremely successful year. The first song you heard was Open Arms by the rock band Journey. Our next selection you will hear from us today is called Autumn Leaves by Joseph Kuzma. We typically like to think that jazz is like strictly an American art form, but very soon in its inception in the early 20th century, it spread throughout the world. So Joseph Kuzma is actually a French composer who is known throughout his life as a film composer. And this is actually one of the very few jazz songs that he dabbled in. But it has become a standard that there are many jazz standards, and a lot of them have been placed in a book we call the Real Book, which is just a collection of 400 plus famous jazz melodies. And this is one of them. So please enjoy Autumn Leaves. Our soloist on this will be Matthew Kane. Again, one of the super fun parts about jazz band that can sometimes make us as performers very cautious and nervous is the chance to solo, but that's not something you get in concert band, in classical music. So this is a very exciting opportunity for students to be able to express themselves. So to all of our students that I have forced to do solos this year, thank you. All right. I've literally made all of them solo. It's great. It's the little bit of power I enjoy wielding. All right, so it is now time to present one of our jazz students with our Louis Armstrong Jazz Award. The last time this was given out here at Dodgeland was all the way back in 2001. I would have been 5 years old. So this is very exciting for us to reestablish. So it's very exciting for us to bring this back and reestablish this tradition. The person receiving this award tonight has shown very strong dedication to the group since the very beginning. They have worked very hard to make the band a fun place to be by bringing an uplifting and positive attitude, as well as displaying a high level of musicianship and raising the bar for their peers. In fact, this person receiving the award has gone so far out of their way to support the group, that they were not even registered for this class this semester. They still came with us on our field trips, and they still learned the music to play with us in our concerts. So can we please get a round of applause for Miss Tara Skalma? You also get this super cool one-of-a-kind, just because it has your name on it. Otherwise, these are mass-produced. But super cool jazz awards. So there you go. So as I've said many times this year, this is the first time we have had an established jazz band in over 21 years. So this is a very big deal for us to have made it this year. And I'm super excited that the band will be growing next year. So that just is so meaningful to me that all the hard work that these students have put in is paying off, that they are establishing their legacy here at school. But enough with that that heartfelt stuff, you know. Let's get back to the music. So our last song we will be playing for you today is Mercy, Mercy, Mercy by Joseph Zonnell. I should have looked up how to say that last name beforehand, but you have it in your program. Awesome. Mercy, Mercy, Mercy.
Since we ruined the surprise, I might as well talk first. All right, good evening. My name is Mr. Menchow. This is my sixth year at the Dodgeland District, and I am super stoked for tonight's concert. Our students have been working hard, our two groups, Vox and Canto Bello, to share our music with you this evening. We begin with a 90s, some might say classic, I do. This is No Rain by Blind Melon.
My point of view, but it's not safe. It's not safe. stay with me and I'll have it made. And I don't understand why I sleep all day, and I start to complain that there's no way. But all I can do is read a book to stay awake, and it rips my life away, but it's a great escape.
That was our first song, No Rain. Our second song of the evening is Walkin' After Midnight, popularized by Patsy Cline. No Rain, Walkin' After Midnight, and later Blackbird were three songs that we performed in Memphis on our music trip, getting to perform at Graceland. And so we wanted to share those with you this evening, as well as a couple other songs that we added since then. So this is Walkin' After Midnight with soloist Rebecca Egbrecht.
Go out walking after midnight, out in the moonlight, just like we used to do. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you.
I walk for miles along the highway, and that's just my way of saying walking after midnight, searching for you. I stop to see a weeping willow crying on his pillow. Maybe he's crying for me. And as the skies turn gloomy, night winds whisper to me, I'm lonesome as I can be. Lonesome as I can be, I go out walking.
Our next selection this evening is Life on Mars by David Bowie. I've been saying Life After Mars, but it's Walking After Midnight, Life on Mars by David Bowie. Again, all these songs from Vox were selected through a process by them. And so we kind of, we at the beginning of the year, did based on a 12-bar blues pattern and picked songs with that. And then we did sort of a name songs for every letter in the alphabet from different eras, and we picked from that. And so Life on Mars, a unique choice, one that I would have not have expected, but I'm stoked about nonetheless. So Life on Mars.
It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair, but her mommy is yelling no, and her daddy has told her to go, but her friend is nowhere to be seen. Now she walks through her sunken dreams to the sea with the clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver screen. But the film is a saddening bore, for she's lived it 10 times or more. She's a spit in the eyes of fools as they ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at those cavemen go. It's the freakiest show. Take a look at the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if you'll ever know. He's in the best-selling show. It's a Life on Mars. Now the workers are struck for fame, 'cause Lenin's on sale again. See the mice in their million hordes, from Ibiza to the Norfolk Broads. Rue Britannia is out of bounds to my mother, my dog, and clowns. But the film is a saddening bore, 'cause I wrote it 10 times or more. It's about to be ripped again as I ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at those cavemen go. It's the freakiest show. Take a look at the lawman beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if he'll ever know. Best-selling show, is there life on Mars?
For awards for Vox, we do things a little differently. So you heard earlier with the concert band that there was the outstanding freshman, sophomore, junior, so on and so forth. Those awards will be coming during our canto bello portion. But for Vox, we have 3 different awards. They are peer selected, and the awards are as follows. The Scarecrow Award, which goes to someone who is outstanding in their field. You have the Turtle Award for someone who has really come out of their shell. And the Unsung Singer Award, which goes to someone who displays leadership qualities beyond their singing ability. And so this evening, the recipients of those awards, we have the Scarecrow Award awarded to Rebecca Egbrecht. The Turtle Award, despite this person commenting on my, mistakes on the piano? I don't call them mistakes, they're spontaneous creative decisions. And I make a lot of them. But our Turtle Award goes to Alyssa Rostelon. And our Unsung Singer Award goes to someone who really is the life of the party in Vox. They bring so much energy to the group, whether it be with a little dance or so during our winter concert. Our Unsung Singer is Sam Walsh. All right. Our next song for you is Blackbird by Lennon and McCartney, popularized by the Beatles. And this song took on extra special meaning when we were in Memphis. As part of our Memphis trip, we toured the National Civil Rights Museum, and the content of Blackbird was written during a period of the Civil Rights Movement. And so being able to sing that song in Memphis, which is a city that played host to a tragic event in American history, took on new meaning. So we hope you enjoy Blackbird.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life, you are only waiting for this moment to arrive. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see. All your life, you were only waiting for this moment to be free.
Our final selection for Vox this evening is a song called Something Big by Shawn Mendes. But before we do that, I just want to acknowledge our seniors in Vox. So if you are a senior, please raise your hand. All right, so a great group of seniors who sadly will be leaving us after this year, but we appreciate them making music with us. And so let's give them a round of applause, please. Once again, this is Something Big by Shawn Mendes. Then we will take just a brief moment to close the curtain and get set for Canto Bello, a few students needing to do a costume change, so to speak, and then we will continue on with this evening's program.
Mm-hmm. feel it when you're just about to kill it. Take your last shot, you know you're gonna hit it. Something's in the air, something's in the air. Whoa. Something big, I feel it happening out of my control. Pushing, pulling, and it's grabbing me. Feel it in my bones like, oh.
This is Canto Bello, our more traditional group, and that was Open Your Eyes, written by John Arkadelt and arranged by Patrick Liebergen, a song, a chamber-type music song from the 1500s. So looking at a variety of genres of music this evening, that's going to be our oldest piece, and we'll work our way through. So that was one piece that we worked on for Memphis and did with a clinic at the University of Memphis. And had a really good time with our with the clinician there, working on our tone and working on various things, and learned quite a bit that we were able to bring back to us here at Dodgeland. Our next song we also did for our clinic in Memphis, and this is Be Still, Jordan, in the style of an African American spiritual. We have two soloists for this one, Holly Granke and Emma Verbane.
Still Jordan, other side. River runs deep, river runs wide, gonna get through to the other side. Be still, Jordan, be still, Jordan. Other side, river runs deep, river runs wide, gonna get through to the other side. Oh, the River Jordan is chilly and cold, yes, my Lord. It chills the body but not the soul, yes, my Lord. Oh, the river runs deep and the river runs wide, but I'm gonna to the other side. River runs deep, river runs wide, gonna get through to the other side. Be still, Jordan, be still, Jordan, be still, Jordan, be still, Jordan.
We have some awards for Canto Bello as well. Our Outstanding Freshman Award. Now, they're laughing because in this particular group, it just so happens we have one freshman. But as they were voting, I did say that should they feel that this individual does not deserve it, they could elect not to vote for them. However, they did carry the votes. They did get the award. Our Outstanding Freshman goes to Mackenzie Starr. A different problem arose when we came to our Outstanding Sophomore, and we had a dead heat. We had a tie, and there was no way I could possibly break the tie. I mulled it over. I considered the options. Therefore, we have co-Outstanding Sophomores, one of which is Vincent Klecker. One thing to be noted about Vincent is that he made it to the State Soul Ensemble Festival held in UW-Whitewater this year, and so congratulations to Vincent for that accomplishment as well. And our second Outstanding Sophomore is Lori Jean Wilson. And we just so happen to have no official award, but a third Outstanding Sophomore. This person auditioned for and was accepted to a statewide honor choir. So we every year have our conference honor choir with schools in our conference, with schools that are our size. This person auditioned for and made it into a statewide honor choir. Over 1,000 people audition for all the honors groups. Only 400 or so make it in. And this person is one of them. So let's give a round of applause for Paris Renhack. We have an Outstanding Junior Award presented to Emma Verbaten. Similar to the concert band, we also have two awards that are specifically for seniors. One of them is the Trojan Pride Award, And this award is chosen by me. I did take input from the choir, and the consensus, their ideas match with mine. And this person has shown dedication to the choir all 4 years of high school and into middle school. I had them as well, and have been involved in other things such as the musical. And so our Trojan Pride Award this year goes to Holly Granke. And lastly, we have the National School Choral Award. And similar to the John Philip Sousa Award and the Louis Armstrong Award, the National School Choral Award is in recognition of singular merit, ability, and achievement of outstanding contributions to the success of the school vocal program and of an unusual degree of loyalty, cooperation, and high qualities of conduct by the general consent of the music faculty, school officials, and others. This year's National School Choral Award is hereby conferred upon Morgan Jornes. It should be noted that Morgan also made it to our State Solo Ensemble Festival in UW-Whitewater, and this last year, and in October, participated in the statewide WSMA Honor Choir, was selected, similarly auditioned and was selected, and got to perform at the Overture Center in October with a group of over 80 other singers from across the state, and so should be commended for those accomplishments as well. Let's give her one more round of applause. She gets a cool little thingy as well. I don't know if Mr. Robinson showed the other ones, but a pin and a I don't know what you call it, but a thingy works for me. Our next song, though the composer of the song has a quite unique pseudonym, Pink Zebra, is a beautiful lyrical piece, which is just a beautiful, I see it kind of as a send-off for our seniors. And so before we sing the song, running the risk of making them cry, seniors, can you raise your hand in this group? Round of applause. You'll notice that they look the same as the seniors in the other group, but should be commended for being in both groups as well. So this is Fly Away Home with soloists Morgan Jornes and Alyssa Rostelin.
Fly away, fly away, fly away home. I'll fly away. dreams last forever. For all that we know, the roads come together, and that's where we'll go.
Before we do our final song, I have some thank yous to give out. And I want to begin tonight in a different order than I usually do. Because the unique reality of our school is that this is a shared space. We share it with the elementary gym students, and we use it for concerts and musicals and other activities. And so last night we had a middle school concert, and we had chairs set up like this, some additional chairs, some on this side. At the end of that concert, those chairs had to all be taken down, put away so we could have gym today, and then set back up for tonight. And it's an extraordinary effort that we go through, and I'm so appreciative of our custodial staff and our maintenance staff, and so I want to give them the first round of applause tonight. I would also like to thank our administrative team for all their support and the ways that they, I already said support, but I'm going to say support again, the ways they support us to help make what we do as successful as it can be. And so we thank the admin team for their support, and we also thank Mr. Brad Modaff and Mr. Josh Jornis, as well as Mr. Bob Sweeney, for their audio, visual, and videography this evening. Let's give them all a round of applause. And lastly, thank you to Mr. John Robinson, for without whom I would not be able to get done half of what I do get done in a day. I'm so thankful for the collaborative spirit that we have together, that we can pass off different things like the program or setup or hey, can you take my students, or so on and so forth. And so we are very fortunate to have Mr. John Robinson teaching our students here at Dodgeland. Let's give him another round of applause. Our final song this evening, if the title looks foreign, that's because it is. It's not in English, or at least a chunk of it is not in English. The text from this is from three different languages. It's Arabic, Bosnian, and Hebrew. The title, Ujedinite Se, translates to stand united. And there are several other phrases that translate to in unity, there is strength, all of us together, join together, open your heart, let's join as one and stand as one. And so this also has a distinctly sort of Arabic sound to it. It's very different than something we normally do, and it's been a challenge to put together, but I hope you enjoy Ujedinite Se.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming and supporting our Dodgeland Music Program. I hope you enjoyed our concert. Safe travels home, and we hope to see you next time. Thank you.